Mr. President. What you are seeing is the first round firing from the HIMARS, high mobility artillery rocket system. The time of flight out to 12 nautical miles of the condition set, approximately 5 minutes from the time of launch. The target aperture that they're shooting at this target, in order to allow all the other agencies to fire, they'll be aiming at the center mast of the ship, basically taking out its communication systems. Following that round, you will see approximately five other rounds following in a sabot to finish off the target. In this case, we've strategically placed the weapon system targets on different parts of the ship in order to allow all the other agencies in this training participation to fire their munitions as well to maximize the training opportunity. Also, maximizing the ability to deconflict and synchronize both joint forces processes in executing a complex target like this. What can happen in reality once we practice and hone our skills down from both partner nations is a near simultaneous attack with all our weapon systems showing a combined arms effect on one target and then ultimately improve to multiple targets at the same time with multiple systems engaging the acquired target. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, as they are waiting for the impact of the round on the target, the CIFC, the Combined Intelligence Execution Cell, located at Camp Aquino, is also processing the other assets in the stack, fixed wing assets, rotor wing assets, and then other surface assets, followed by this with artillery. After the battle damage assessment is made, they will readjust and reacquire the target if necessary and fire the remaining salvo from the HIMARS rockets. preparing.
Once the HIMARS has finished firing its remaining 5 rounds, we will be shifting to artillery fire. The HIMARS will be extricating from its firing position, and the crew for both the US and Philippine artillery will be positioning themselves at the position in front of us, the tower. The targets for the artillery fire will be a secondary target, which is much nearer. It will be located 4.7 nautical miles. The target is going to be killer tomato drums that are tied together with bamboo pontoons. Once the artillery fire is done, we will transition to aviation assets. Another round? Okay, another round on the way. HIMARS? Okay, okay. Hindi namin mag-monitor kung tama. Okay, okay. Yes, yes. Okay, okay. Fire na lang yun. Fire na lang. Fire, do you hear me? sir, they are preparing for the following fires right now. They've zoomed out the viewing aperture of the Hermes. Locate the following rounds. The CFC is currently issuing orders already to the firing battery.
Of communication right now. First is the station controlling the MQ-9, which observed the impacts of the first HIMARS shock, which was approximately 60 to 90 meters away from the vessel. Considering that the six rocket points had to open a sheath and go to different points, right now the Fire Direction Center is just assessing more updates as the vessel is drifting so it can be in the correct location. As I understand, we are ongoing the concurrent loading with the second HIMARS with the remaining five rockets. And as soon as that HIMARS says that it is ready to go, a new fire mission will be generated and sent down to the launch room. other actions that SIPC is taking at this time. We are coordinating with Coast Guard vessels to the north of the area to confirm the search area is clear. We're also coordinating with three aliens to the south that are confirming the surface area is clear. The HIMARS that is currently on the ground is reporting that it is nearing completion to receive the fire mission. As soon as that call is given ready, the MQ-9 will give an updated target grid to the command center located near the SIFC. That fire mission will be sent to the Fire Direction Center down at the Wallace.
We just received word from the firing unit. They will be firing within a minute, sir.
Hey, all stations, this is 3rd Marty of John Kane, air interloper, Kane.
SIFC acknowledges I'm working with the lab MLR element. They have the LNO with the Civilian Air Authority working the deconfliction at this time.
We are expecting to complete fire within 2 to 5 minutes. Sir, in order to fully appreciate the process it takes to engage the target, it all begins with the detection coming from our sensors. And in this case, it is represented by the Hermes 900. That information, together with all other redundant sensors, are being fed into the different joint task forces. involved there is Olcom and the three Mardiv. And that is when they start initiating the kill chain that ends up in the CFC that is being shown in the screen right now. From the CFC, they have the common operational picture of the entire area and the entire coordination and deconfliction between the different firing units are processed in that particular location before it is, the orders are handed over to the firing units. At the same time, you also have picket vessels from the Philippine Navy and Philippine Coast Guard that are securing the Opera Box. These vessels are seeing to it that they are enforcing the notice to mariners, preventing any commercial and local fishing vessels from passing through the operational area. Just informed that there has been one air interloper that entered into the Opera Box and that's been pushed out. We have now deconflicted the airspace. Sir, currently the range is cold because of a safety issue. There is because of the interloper that has been reported. We are waiting for the range to clear once the... Yeah. Once the interloper has left the opera box.
Third Martin John, this is Tipsy.
Go ahead, Tipsy.
At this time, I am tracking one remaining air interloper break. MLR is assessing they'll be out of the airspace shortly. Break. And they have just called Kobe request slaughter.
Roger, standby. Roger, confirm slaughter.
Roger, tracking slaughter from Third Martiv, slaughter. Now that the range has been cleared, the HIMARS is ready. An updated target location will be sent from the Marine Littoral Regiment to the ADOC Ford located next to the 6C. From that, the fire mission information will be sent to the Fire Direction Center down at Net DC and then subsequently submitted to the launcher. This will be a win-ready mission.
Third Marine Division, Jock, Roger.
Mark has now sent the fire mission to the ADOT forward located next to the SIF-C, and that mission has been received. That has been currently being processed and will be sent down to NetDC shortly.
Sir, to explain, the range is now green. The CFC will now process the kill chain and they will send the order directly to the firing battery. Sir, right now they're going through all the safety procedures to ensure that the Opera Box is safe. And once the CFC has given the approval, they will release the round of the IMARS.
The fire mission from the ADOC forward has been sent down to the Fire Direction Center at NetDC.
Currently, right now, the order from the CFC has been sent to the Fire Direction Center for firing.
Recording is on.
Sir, that was the last remaining 5 rounds from the HIMARS. After target confirmation, we will shift to artillery fire. The HIMARS will extricate from their fighting position, and the crew of the combined artillery of the AFP and the United States will be proceeding to their fighting positions.
Gamma, fireball. Fireball, Gamma.
Fireball, Gamma. Fireball.
Sir, for info, sir, Mercury. Gamma, fireball.
High Mars to move clear out of the danger area. 5 and 155 fires. As soon as that is clear, the 105 and 155 crews will arrive Gamma, to their Gamma, firing fireball. Locations, and we will commence firing with the tube artillery.
Sir, bomb, sir, Mercury, sir.
Sir, we have already transitioned to artillery fire. Directly in front of us are our AFP artillery assets. The artillery pieces you see at center are our self-propelled artillery, our Atmos. To its right is our 155mm howitzer from the Philippine Marines, and 105s at its left. United States Army artillery is located to the left of that position, sir.
So, Mr. President and team, as a recap of what happened earlier, the HIMARS fired their first volley of one round towards the target. Upon that, that rocket being fired and time of flight happening, if you look to your right, the rotating object is a TPS-80 Gator, ground air task-oriented radar ran by the Marine Corps, coupled with the MQ-9 asset. So even with the MQ-9 covering up to 200 nautical miles of sea, complemented with the radar system, we have complementary ISR assets and capabilities to detect a private, unregistered single craft aircraft in the middle of the ocean, and then call the range code for safety parameters and then re-engage into the attack. During the time of re-engage, the vessel is still moving, which means that the battery and the FDC must reacquire the target, set a new technical firing solution, maintain custody of that target with our ISR assets and our radar on the ground, and then re-engage the target. As you see, the salvos have fired from the HIMARS, and the dust trail off of the coast was the HIMARS rapid exfiltration of the AO, setting the conditions for their artillery battery to now engage from another element of ground to surface-to-surface missile firing.
The HIMARS unit is now pulling out. Once the range is cleared for overhead fire, the artillery units will start engaging. The artillery batteries will be engaging a secondary target that's located 4.7 nautical miles away.
But we are awaiting clearance from the interloper.
Thermar Dibjock, copy. HIMARS are clear.
Recording is on.
Request slaughter.
Sip C, third more dip jock. Say again, over.
I tracking Slaughter at 1024 and Monstar is at 1024.
Roger, tracking.
Monstar.
Sir, CFC is tracking an interloper inside of artillery range. Artillery has been given approval to fire. Sir, the combined artillery units have been given clearance to fire at their command.
Thank you. The weapon demonstration is now complete by the ground forces of the Philippine Army, Philippine Marine Corps, and the United States Army. We will now see the air portion of today's live fire demonstration. We will now see the air portion of today's live fire demonstration. Starting off, the airborne portion will be the U.S. Marine Corps Marine Light Attack Helicopter Squadron 267, Flying Attack Helicopter 1 Cobra, attached to the 13th Marine Expeditionary Unit. The AH-1 Cobra conducted its first flight in 1965 and is currently in service in both the United States and the Philippines. The AH-1 Cobra has a range of over 570 kilometers and a top speed of 276 kilometers per hour.
Firestorm, Parbol, go ahead, sir. Philippine Army, Philippine Marines, rounds complete. Next. Copy, sir. Copy, sir. Copy.
The AH-1 Cobra will be departing from Basa and it will enter checkpoints Portland and Canary to enter the Opera Box and engage the target and leave Dove checkpoint after he engages the target. On the video screen to your left, we'll be showing a graphic presentation of the Cobra entering the Opera Box and firing the deep target. At this moment, the Commander Nolcom and the Commander 3rd Mardiv is conducting battle damage assessment at CFC Nolcom.
Third Marine Division Jock. The NOLCOM command team is requesting to converse regarding the BDA and continuing the strike package.
Roger, stand by.
At this moment, the commander of the Joint Task Forces is conducting battle damage assessment, and after which, they will follow up on the air attack plan.
CFC JTF.
This is a CFC.
Hey, we're down on Hermes feet. Can you confirm that there's no collateral? They've conducted a collateral scan and there's no concerns over?
Stand by, sir. Hermes feed is also on our end. We're working to correct how the MQ-9 is assessing as we speak. Over. From the STIF-C, MQ-9 passes. They're going to take approximately 2 more minutes to complete collateral scans to ensure there are no safety issues.
JTF copies all. We'll wait the 4 minutes, and we're back up on Hermes, so we're looking at the scan there. Commodore DiCaprio, this is General Bargeron. We've got just a few more items to check here, and then we'll be ready for an update brief and PDA. Over.
Thank you.
JTF, this is SIFC. MQ-9 reports the collateral scans are complete and the area is clear.
From JTF, the collateral scans are, collateral scans are clear at 10:51. We'll go through the weapons effectiveness and BDA update brief. All right, Commodore, updated grid location of Romeo Bravo 1088683. That was validated by RG2. AIS and MQ9 had a collateral scan at 10:59, and the area was clear. And at 10:57, and it was clear. And at 10:53, we were notified via the Coast Guard and Phil Navy that there were no collateral concerns. Based on the current weapons effectiveness and BDA, previous executed strikes. We continue with Strike Package Alpha, leading off with the section of H-14 view. And then we'll follow it up with an event RSO clearance. Looking for concurrence from you and the J, sir.
Yeah, over to you, Commodore.
This is the ATF protocol. Over.
Yes, okay, thank you. So I concur with that. We're going to check the thumbs up here.
I'll check.
Sounds good.
Okay, we got an RSO confirmation, affirmative. So concur with everyone, and green range once more. Brevity code Slaughter.
Slaughter.
This is SIFC, acknowledge Slaughter. 1101 Slaughter at 1101.
Continue with Strike Package Alpha as scheduled by the staff.
SIFC acknowledge continuing Strike Package Alpha at 1130 for the AH-1s to commence their engagement.
Affirmative, and then execute schedule that follows.
Right now, the Opera box is in yellow status, which means the range is clear and awaiting for engagement assessment to commence the 13th Marine Expeditionary Unit Rotary Wing. At this
recording
moment,
is on.
The Joint Task Force commanders are resetting the range to ensure the Opera Box is safe to engage. The viewing of the president has now ended. The president is now proceeding to the tent area.
Check 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.